Hello everyone, this is Rohit Manoharan and welcome back to the Checkpoint Lab training. For this video, we'll be seeing how to implement a policy based on time. With that, we'll be seeing how to give some rules, section titles and implement inline layers in it. Okay, so talking about time-based policy, it's basically you can allot a time to a given rule in the policy table. So to show that, I will jump into our Windows machine. So I have logged into a smart console, as you can see. So for this, I will jump into security policy. And I deleted the unnecessary policy because we don't need that, okay? So I only placed one policy, which is zone, and we discussed it in previous video, how we added a zone-based policy. So as you can see, we have a destination. Okay, let me do one thing. Let me bring my Epic pen. Sorry. Epic pen, yeah. Okay. Okay. So, to see that, yeah. So as you can see, we have a zone-based policy and it's from inside to outside and services are any. Earlier I mentioned HTTP, SSH and all, and I am accepting all that traffic. Whichever the traffic which comes from inside, which is E0 interface, and which is going to outside, which is E1, any service, using any services or application, I am fine with that. Just permit that traffic which I accept. Okay, so this is the default policy which I added, but you can actually add time to this policy, which means specifically you have to use this rule in a allotted time. To create that, we have to create an object. Okay, so to create an object, there are two ways. I will show you another way. Okay, so you have to click on this objects bar, which will open the object bar. There are 21 network objects, services objects are 511, application objects are 711. So you have to create a new object. For that, you have to click here. And as the drop down list comes, and you see that it has network host, network group, there is a more option. Okay, I will click on more. And under that, you can see time. And then time group means you have to select multiple times. So I will go for single time, means a specific time. So I will go for time. Yeah, right now the time, okay, so I have to name it. So my rule will be, what is the time right now? Yeah. Let's just check the time. It's 6:25 and I want it for some time, right? Okay, so I can just start at, which means you have to start at this, and you can set the date also. Okay, if you don't want this, you can select the hour ranges, which means in this hour ranges particularly you have to start it. Okay, and you can select days in week, means it's clear from the word that you can select specific days in a week or days in a month. So I will go for 6. Yeah, I will edit it out, and it's right now 6:12. Okay, and my num block is off, that's why. Okay, I can simply click on this. Okay, great. So it's 6:12, which means 6 hours this rule will be in effect. So what I have to do is simply click on, oh, I didn't type the name, so I will give it. It's my Sunny type. Yeah. Sunny. Okay, great. Okay, I will go for OK. And the time object is created. There are already 4 time objects. And what you have to do is simply click on that. And it shows. There is every day, off work, sunny, sunny, and there is weekend. Okay. So to set this time to a specific rule, what you have to do is, as you can see, there is no title here. Okay, there is no title in this video. It's the title in this section bar. Okay, so what you have to do is simply click on this section bar, right? And you have to make sure this check mark is clicked, which is time. And when you click that, we have an extra column, which is time. And then you can mention your time object. So you have to click on plus. And I'll choose Sunny. Okay, great. Now, what you have to do is, okay, I will tell you one more thing in this video, that you can specify a specific firewall which this rule should be implemented on. So that is this install on, which means you have to simply click on this and it will show you the number of devices which it is, which it has. So there are two devices which this rule can be implemented on, which is CPSG1 and CPSG2. So I will only implement it in CPSG1 as I have not defined any inside or outside interface in CPSG2. So I will just click on CPSG1. Next, what you have to do is simply publish and install this policy. So I'll go for publish and click on publish. Yeah, the admin made these changes and it will be recorded. Yeah, great. And then you have to basically install this one. Install on SD1, I don't want it. Basically, the second rule will be applied to this. If you don't, if you leave that check mark, it doesn't matter. So I am just removing it. Because I have specified that implement this rule in SD1 only. Okay, there have been a couple of fails earlier because the interface was changed and I just fixed it in the exercise server. Let's see if it gets implemented or not. I just added a time and it's successful. Yes, it's successful as you can see. Installation succeeded on CPSG1. So this was about time-based policy. Now talking about section titles. Section titles is a good topic because you have to, if you have a number of rules in this list, if you have 1,000 rules in the policy table, you have to sort it out, right? So to sort it out, you have to make section titles. Inside that section titles, you can set inline layers. So let's discuss about this. Okay, let's discuss about this and we'll jump into that after. Okay, so section titles basically means if you have a couple of rules, and I will show, okay, these rules as this and consider it as rule 1, rule 2, and it goes on. Okay, so section title means you are giving all the sections a simple title. Okay, consider it as management rules. Means these 5 rules are management rules. Okay, these are management rules. You just gave it a title. Okay, what do inline layers mean? Okay, so in inline layers, if these 3 rules are sort of similar, okay, are sort of similar, and these 2 rules are sort of similar, so you can create a parent rule which signifies the common thing in this. Okay, consider if my source here is PC1 and my source here is manager being the .110, okay, and PC is .120, so I can combine this rule as a single parent rule, and if it has a drop down list, and I will add this specific rule inside as child. Means I will create a parent rule which tells that these 2 rules are combined and its action is this. And if you drop down me, you can see my child rules which are as following, which will be separate rules, which In that you can see this, it has rule 1 and rule 2. So parent rule means I will create a parent to this part. Okay. So for that I will just go to my machine. Yeah. Let me clear off this and let me make code. Yeah. So what you have to do to add a section, you have to basically right click on it. Not here. You have to right click on a rule. Sorry. Okay. Right click on it and you have to give a section title. So I will give a section title here, which basically I will signify as my zone, zone traffic. Okay. You can give it anything. And as you can see, it shows us it's 1 to 2, means there are two rules and it shows like that. So it's 1 to 2, it's sections for 1 and 2. Okay. So I will hit enter and this is how you create a section. It's very simple. You have to go to that rule. And if you want it above or below, you have to simply right click on this and you have to select if you want it above or if you want it below. So I will give it a cleanup rule section. So cleanup rule. Cleanup is different rule. Okay. There are two sections and now we will see how to create a parent rule. Okay. To create a parent rule, you have to simply click. So let me create some plain rules first. Before creating this inline rule, so I will create some random rules which will do nothing. So I will just create it and I will create a new one below this. Oh, sorry, I just added a section. And one more thing, you can navigate these sections by just simply clicking on this, and you can just see, this bar is a navigation bar for this section. So you can just simply click and place it wherever you want. Okay. So right now, I will delete this because I don't need this. I have already two titles. Okay. Click on yes. Yeah. So I have created two rules. Now it's time for inline rule. Or let me add one more rule for fun. Add it below. Okay, so I will give it a section as a router. And inside that, I will create a new rule. Below. Okay, great. So there are a couple of rules, and I will name it something. So what you have to do is go for names like this, and a little bit scrolling left, and I will give some names, random names. This will be A rule, this will be B rule, and I will not publish it because it will ruin my configuration. That's why, just to show you, or I will publish and discard it. It's okay. Okay, so there are a couple of rules. There are total 5 rules. Now, what you have to do is to create inline rules, right? Yeah, to create inline rule, you have to simply go to right side and get to action. So if you want to create an inline rule, which means 1.1, this is the parent rule and you have to create an inline rule, to go to action, simply right click on it and it will show you 3 options, and you can see there is an inline option also. Inline layer option. You have to go for inline layer and add a new layer, which means it will add a child layer, which is 1.1. And I will create an object which will be like add. Yeah. And it's random. I'm just making it random. And it's an object. And as you can see, we in action, we have add. And under that, you can actually close and minimize this by clicking on this, close and maximize it, and close and open it or close and minimize it. So these are the child rules, and you can add each and every time by right clicking any rule, and it shows that your action is add, which means source being the inside, destination being the outside, services are any, but actions are add. Add means you have to go and check my child rules for the action. So currently it has dropped, so it will be dropped. So you can create more inline layers. How means it completely depends on you. If you want to create more than one layer, you can create it, or you can specifically edit that layer too. Means you can edit the newly created layer also. Okay. So I will create one more layer for you. You have to go for right click, more, and say right click inline layer and create a new one. So I will create this rule as minus. Okay. So I have created a new layer which is minus, and means I just changed the add to minus because it's dropped. Okay. Create one more rule in this. You have to simply click on this and add a rule below. Add a rule below, which will be 1.2. Yeah, it's 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, whatever you want. So I just, you can change the object, you can edit out the objects. It's completely up to you what you have to do. So these are changes. And one more thing, that after you complete it, you have to basically, and you have to basically publish it and install it. Okay. And the other thing that I want to say it here is, in corporate environment, make sure you categorize your each and every policy, because it's easier to find it. Okay. I will show you one. So these are my zone traffic routes. Okay. So to minimize, you have to simply click on this one. And these are my router routes. Okay, 1 minute. It's little bit stuck because it's in remote location as well. So these are my router rules, and these are my zone traffic. These are extra cleanup rules. So as you can see, it's little bit organized. So whenever you want a change, you can go to the specific part and change the rule. Okay, so it works like that. And that's it about this topic, that you can add inline layers to specific layers. You can add an inline layer. You can give the inline layer a name, which means you have to create an object for that inline layer. And under that object, you will have the specific sub layers, means to that parent rule, you will have sub layers. Okay. So that's it. You have to simply publish it that I made these changes, and you have to click on install. That will do the thing. And you can actually discard these changes by clicking on discard, which means no, I would just want to restart this things again. So you have to go for discard and click discard. It will discard all the policies, means whatever changes you have made. Okay, if I go for discard, we'll show you. It will revert to back. Yeah, so it reverted to back, and I have only two rules. Okay, so if you are making section titles and this, you have to make sure you have to install the policy. Okay, so I am not installing it because it can cause me error. That's why. So let me do one thing. Let us make it as in. Okay, every day looks fine. And I will publish it. Okay, I will create one section, which is zone, for you guys. Let me do it again for you. It's very simple. You have to go here and go for above. I will name it zone. If you want, you can create inline rule by creating right click on this and go for inline layer and add a new layer, which will ask you, can I create a object for inline layer? And then you will have 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, etc. So I am not creating any inline layer because I have only one rule and I have nothing to make it common. So I will not add. So I will go for publish these changes. And it's publishing, and I have to basically install it. And install it in 501. I'm okay with that. I'm fine with that, and it will take a little bit time. Okay. So that's it about inline layers, section titles, and time-based policy. Okay, that's it. And you have to minus this Sunny also. It's installed, as you can see, installation complete. These are the previous ones which failed when I accidentally changed the interface. Okay, these are the previous ones. That's why it's still here. Okay, one more thing that you can check the logs. So I will discuss it in brief at the troubleshooting part. It's very needed how to troubleshoot a policy. So I will discuss it in another video. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you liked it, and bye-bye.